What's up guys, welcome back to the channel. In today's video, I'm going to be doing a Star Wars movie tier ranking. As I'm sure some of you guys know, I've never actually ranked all of the Star Wars movies 1 through 11. I find it to be an excessively difficult thing to do, but today we're gonna try it out. Every time I try to rank the movies, I end up looking back at the list and I'm like, well, I could swap this or that, and I never feel super strongly about it, but we're gonna try and do a tier list today and see how we go. So we'll start things out here. On the left with The Rise of Skywalker, and I know I'm gonna rattle some cages right off the bat. I'm probably going to surprise some people, but we're gonna start out with The Rise of Skywalker up in S tier. It's my favorite movie of the sequel trilogy. It's in competition for my favorite Star Wars movie, period. I know a lot of people won't agree, but that's how I feel. We'll see how this list changes as I make my way through it. I may shuffle things around a little bit as I get to the end, but next up we have Rogue One. A bit of a hot take here. Rogue One is a good movie, but I think a lot of people have it like up in their upper echelon, like maybe S tier, A tier, maybe B tier. I'm gonna put it in C tier for now. It might move. Like I said, it's a good movie, but I do find myself getting bored at times when I'm watching it. I find that the first half of the movie is relatively slow. I like the characters, I like the story. It's probably gonna move actually, but I'm gonna leave it there for now. The Last Jedi is above Rogue One. It's probably my least favorite sequel. It has a lot of good things that I really enjoy, but it also still has some things that I'm not a big fan of. I love pretty much everything about the dynamic between Rey and Kylo in this movie. I like most of what they do with Luke. I love the way the movie handles Leia. I feel that it really pushes Poe Dameron into a bigger role. It definitely does some good things. I definitely really like this movie, don't get me wrong. I'm gonna put it in B tier for now. It might move up to A, but I think B tier is good. And then I'm gonna put The Force Awakens up in A tier, slightly above The Last Jedi. This used to be a much bigger gap. I would have probably had like Force Awakens in S or A tier and Last Jedi down in C tier. But these movies are very close. I'm gonna have them in separate tiers for now though. Solo. I've always said this about Solo. Solo is pretty much as good as you could expect a movie about Han Solo to be. I enjoy it when I watch it, but I also find that it's the movie that I don't really rewatch. It's good, but when I watch Star Wars, like generally speaking, I'm looking for, you know, the mystery and the mythology of the Force and the Jedi and the Sith, and Solo obviously doesn't have that. I don't know, like, it's a good story and I enjoy it. I'm gonna put it in D tier for now. I might move that. Empire Strikes Back is not necessarily my favorite movie to go back and rewatch, but I do really enjoy rewatching it actually, and I mean, it's goated. I'm gonna put it in S tier. It's a very good movie. Phantom Menace is Phantom Menace is near the bottom of my list, I'm not gonna lie. It's not that I don't like it, I do. I'm gonna put it in D tier though. I just find that it moves pretty slowly when I rewatch it. I like Qui-Gon. Darth Maul is cool, even though he has a very small role in the movie. It's cool to see young Anakin, but it's definitely toward the bottom of my list. A New Hope, I want to put A New Hope in the same tier as Rogue One, honestly. You know what? I'm going to move The Last Jedi up, and I'm going to go like this. We'll see. I might change that again, but Return of the Jedi is S tier for me. The first half is a little wacky, but I mean, that comes with the territory with Star Wars, and I absolutely love the second half of the movie. Might be the best ending to any Star Wars movie there is. Attack of the Clones is going to be right on par with The Phantom Menace down toward the bottom. Revenge of the Sith is S tier. I need to move this around a little bit down here. This is not my definitive ranking yet, guys. Hold on. I'm going to move Attack of the Clones into C tier. Because I said this in a video a little while back, but whenever I think about the prequels, for some reason I tend to place The Phantom Menace above Attack of the Clones, just when I think about what they bring to the table. But the last time I watched the prequel trilogy, I actually enjoyed Attack of the Clones quite a bit more than The Phantom Menace, so I'm going to stick with that. Solo kind of has to be in the D tier for me because I do like the rest of the films more than Solo in terms of like when I go rewatch them, or if I'm going to go rewatch a movie, it's going to be one of these other 10 films. So Solo is going to be at the bottom. Not because it's not a good movie, but it just, it's not on the level of the other ones for me. So we're going to leave that there. And I think, nah, these two are like pretty even for me too, though. You know what? I'm moving all these back down. This is really hard for me, guys. How about, okay, let's just get rid of the D tier and go like that. There we go. We got an S tier, A tier, B tier, C tier. Screw the D tier. And I mean, I think I feel pretty good about that. These two could, not really The Force Awakens. Maybe, yeah. These two could move down one maybe, but then these would have to move down two. Like, because I like The Last Jedi and The Force Awakens more than I like Rogue One or A New Hope. But they definitely don't belong up in this. I could potentially move Empire Strikes Back down to A tier. Because I don't think it's quite on the level of these three, which perhaps unironically are the three conclusions to each respective trilogy. I guess I'm a sucker for the endings, but I'm gonna leave that how it is. Empire Strikes Back, honestly, like Empire Strikes Back is probably a better movie in terms of quality and story than Return of the Jedi, but the ending of Return of the Jedi is just so gripping for me that it's S tier. And Revenge of the Sith, you know, I don't think I really have to justify that too much. I think most people are going to agree that Revenge of the Sith is S tier. It's a great payoff to the original trilogy and to the prequels, despite how tragic it is. And then The Rise of Skywalker, I think you guys know how I feel about that movie. Of course it has its flaws like every film does. Did I want Ben Solo to live? Yes. Do I hope he still comes back at some point somehow? Yes. But Rise of Skywalker is, it's top of the line for me. So that's my ranking for now. You know, it could be different tomorrow, it could be very different a year from now, but I feel pretty decent about that. So that's gonna wrap things up for me. If you enjoyed this video and you'd like to see me do more stuff like this in the future, let me know in the comments. Thank you all for watching. I will catch you in the next video, and remember, the Force will be with you always.